Foot Health Week is in April, and one of the best ways to celebrate is by putting on a challenge. Hey everyone, welcome back to my Podiatry channel. My name is Deidré if we're meeting for the first time. In this video, I am going to challenge you to love on your feet, and I mean really love on your feet. So if you're someone who neglects your feet, feel like you don't have time for your feet, but you still have big goals for your feet, then this challenge is for you. This challenge is for absolutely everyone, including children. So no matter what your feelings are about your feet, no matter what you think about your feet, even if you think that they're a bit yucky, then this challenge is still for you. And here's why. Your feet are the strongest part of your body. And in my opinion, they are the most important part of your body because they're carrying all of you. So imagine you didn't have your feet. You would have to then think about another way of getting around. So think about that for a moment. And then think about those who only have one foot. And then think about those who have no feet at all. And then realize how lucky you are to have both of your feet. With that being said, even if you are an amputee, you can still take part in this challenge. Just make sure that you get medical advice or speak to your healthcare provider to make sure that it's safe for you to do so. Also, if you are recovering from an injury, you have a diabetic foot, you have poor eyesight or reduced mobility, make sure you also seek medical advice before you take part in the challenge. This is one of those videos that I suggest you watch in full, then come back each day for 5 days until you've completed all the challenges. And we're starting right now. Welcome to day one of the 5 days Foot Health Challenge. First of all, let me congratulate you on joining the challenge. This shows real commitment to yourself and your foot health goals. So well done to you. Today, I challenge you to look at your feet twice throughout the day. And the reason why we're looking at your feet twice is because throughout the course of the day, your feet changes. So if anything was to change, you will notice. So the first check is before you put your shoes on to start your day. And then the second check will be at the end of the day. So basically when you're winding down for the evening. Here are some of the things that I want you to look out for. And I highly suggest that you write these down in a journal with the date and the time of the day. Are your feet the same color? Are there any breaks in the skin, especially in between the toes? Do you have hair on your feet? And if so, are they growing nicely? What is the temperature of your feet? Are they the same temperature? Is it warm? Is it cool? Or is it hot? Is there a marked difference between the temperatures on the left foot and the right foot? Any deformities? For example, do you have a bunion? Do you have a hammer toe or do you have a claw toe? Is your skin dry? Do you have a skin infection? Do you have any hard skin? How do your nails look? Are they white or are they discolored? Are they thick or are they thin? Are they brittle? Are they ingrown? Anything that you notice that, that might be something, I want you to write these down. Welcome to day two of the 5 days Foot Health Challenge. I hope that day one was a nice introduction to warm you up to taking better care of your feet. Today, I challenge you to use your four senses. That's right. And to do this, I am going to ask you to be barefoot. And this is the only time I will ever ask you to go barefoot. Find three different textures that could be indoors or outdoors. For example, the carpet. And then I want you to answer these questions. What does it look like? What does it feel like? How does it sound underneath your feet? And how does it smell? Make sure that you're making notes of all the answers to these questions. Diabetes affects the entire body. So this is a great challenge for someone who is newly diagnosed with diabetes, like myself, with no known diabetic complications. Because if anything changes, you will know. And you will also have this written record to refer back to if anything was to change later on down the line. Welcome to day 3 of the 5 days foot health challenge. We are at the halfway point now, and I hope that you're really starting to have fun and enjoy this challenge. Now is time to bring in the little feet. So today I challenge you to check your child or children's feet. Repeat the questions from day 1 of the challenge. Depending on the age of the child and the level of their activities, not all the questions will be compatible for them, but it's still good practice to ask them the questions to get them really aware and thinking about their feet. Then I want you to ask them, how are their feet feeling? And I want you to really pay attention to how they describe their feet and the things that they actually say about their feet. Be sure to write down everything that they're telling you about their feet. Do not worry if you don't have access to a child. You can still take part in this challenge by calling someone that you know who has a child. Give them the challenge and have them feed it back to you. Welcome to day 4 of the challenge. Now, this challenge is going to be very difficult for some of you, and that's okay. Today, I challenge you to assess all your footwear, and then I want you to throw out all the shoes that you know is causing you pain and discomfort. If you're not ready to complete this challenge, then that is okay. Just remember why you joined the challenge in the first place. Then take some time to reevaluate and then try the challenge again. Welcome to day 5 of the 5 days foot health challenge. You made it to the end. Congratulations. I am super, super proud of you. Well done. There are 26 bones in each foot, and those bones make up the 3 arches inside of the foot. So there's one on the inside, there's one on the outside, and then there's one across the foot. And they act as a shock absorber, and they also support the foot. How many times have you been asked when you go shoe shopping, do you know what your foot type is? And how many times do you look at them and say, no, I don't know? Today, I challenge you to tell me your foot type. Do you have an arch? Is it flat, normal, or is it high, or is it collapsed? When you're standing straight, do your feet turn inwards or outwards? This is a great challenge for 2 reasons. The first reason is you won't have to rely on the salesperson to tell you your foot type. And the second reason is being aware of your foot type puts you in a position to make better choices when choosing footwear. And here is a bonus challenge. If you are someone living with diabetes, let me know in the comment, when was your last diabetic foot health assessment? What is your risk category? And finally, how often do you get your feet checked? And friends, that's it. That is the end of the 5 days foot health challenge. I hope you enjoy this challenge as much as I did. And if that's the case, please leave me some feedback or some comments, and I will leave the link for this in the description. Thank you so very much for taking part in this challenge. My name is Deidré, and I will see you next time.